First they couldn't sail out, now they don't have a boat to do it. Well, those Vikings really solved their problem. And I think it's time to rest here because my magic's all depleted. Let's see, what do I do from this point? Sail out, looking for the next place. Unfortunately, the seas have a high encounter rate, decently high encounter rate, and long stretches. That boat is slow. Damn, is the boat slow. Look at these guys. What even is this existence? Yep, I know I'm gonna have to sail a pretty distance to get to the next area. It's actually, there's multiple places you can go, and one of them has magic. You might want to go there first and pick it up before you go on to the next main area. Or you could just look very confused at a guide trying to figure out where you're supposed to go. And then sort of halfway go there, feel like you need to turn around the whole point, and then push it, you know, a couple feet farther and you actually make it there. That's what happens to me at the very least. Well, this is quite a long gap. It's something I would cut out if I wasn't doing post-commentary and I didn't want to stop it and have to sink two or three times instead of just once. But that's okay. We're having fun, aren't we? You having a good time? I hope you're having a good time. I know this one's a little different from the other two. And this series is a little different from the other playthroughs. But I hope you're enjoying it. It's time to go! Oh, this village. This is not the village we're supposed to go to next. Thank you. That's a little grim. Sorry, Billy, your dad's dead. Sorry, Billy, your dad is dead. Boarded up houses. A giant tree that moves. Oh, I was thinking I was at a different point in the game. Yeah, Jizal is not in this part of the game. We're going to Castle Argus. So Tokal is a place we should be going to get some items before we head out to Argus. My mistake. Sonic and Knuckles. Just more sail in the seas. Alright, here we get to the castle. Oh, they have surprise faces. It looks, it's adorable. So basically right now you don't have to go to this castle, but there is a shit ton of decent items to pick up. Here I'm trying to put some attack items up near the top since they're still very useful. Yeah, Arctic Wind. That's a really good one. Can do some serious damage tossing those all around. Very unwise strategic decision. That's the best you can think of. I like that. They're out pillaging villages like good soldiers of Doom. That's a good line. Just so matter of fact. Yes, I think there's a lot of general confusion about where this is the first part of the game where I really get confused about where it wants me to go. This game is kind of bad about that. In a way that none of the future Final Fantasy games have that problem. You know where you need to go with those ones. This one, like, there's so many points in the game where it's just too open without really giving you any indication of where you should, like, what your goal is. Like, where you should be heading. I don't know why I just don't just straight up attack these things. Thank you. to ride. There's a chocobo forest up here. Oh, and the Village of the Ancients. That's over here. Okay. I just noticed that the Village of the Ancients is on the very edge of the floating continent, so they are very aware that it is, in fact, a floating continent. A little choppy. Wonder what's causing that. He will give you a prize. I don't think it's worth it though. For the time it might take. Well, they're serpent swords, so if you wanted to dual-wield electric blades, have at it. Pretty good if you're sailing, I guess. Lightning weapons are very useful against sea creatures in general, which is why the Viking, all its hammers are lightning elemental. Makes sense. Sense. It's a level 1 white magic, but you can't get it until here, because the idea that you're on a floating continent is supposed to be sort of hidden from you until this point. That's smart. That's smart. I like it. Teleport. That's so useful. Get you out of dungeons without having to backtrack. Really can't complain about that. That missing level 2 magic's gonna be Toad. You get that story one. You acquire that when it's necessary storyline wise, so don't worry about it. White magic's a little spotty at the beginning of the game, since you only get 3 of the 6. White magic spells until the game decides it's a good time for you to learn it. Thank you. I slept like a log. Chocobo, but you don't really need chocobos in this game, really. It's kind of the weird thing. There's like no real points where you have to use a chocobo. It's just there. So the dungeon is actually like past this. Here's Golden Gulch. Can glimpse into the future. I heard a rumor. I like it. Even though he just got told 3 seconds ago, he thinks it's a rumor. There's Toad. Thank you. So, let's get to that tower. First, let's grab some gear. See that thing swirling around in the lake down there? Hidden dungeon. You gotta come back much later in the game though. It's very easy to go that direction. You actually have to go to the right first. Or no. God damn it, I always forget where that tower is. It's right next to where the two peninsular horns meet, and there's a little whirlpool that keeps your ship from going past. We'll be right back. Here we go. There's the tower. I had forgotten to get myself more toads, which is what I'm doing now. It's one of those things, you cast it, you walk in, then you cast it again to remove it. You kind of, like, it just kind of wastes two of your spell slots. I only got 7 charges, when I really know I only got 5. Time to take a dip. I hate toads. Don't turn me into one. Well, actually, Rifia, you're turning yourself into one. I do like that you can have a conversation between the toads. What I'm realizing right now, I think. Spooky voice. Not spooky voice. Thank you. Hee hee hee. There's a lot of hidden items in this area, so I'm trying to figure out where they actually are. Salamand sword, that's like the serpent sword, but fire damage. Almost there. One of the ancients. All right, boss time. I like how she has a body in that model, but it's literally just the head in this one. I wonder if it's based off Castlevania. Like that style presentation of Medusa. And she's down for the count. Time for Desh to save the day. Dash. Just jumps into molten lava. Very short-lived sadness for that sacrifice. Well, that's the end of the game where Desh is part of our party, which is, you know, he was there for 3-4 areas. That's a pretty good amount of time for a guest character. Anyway, guys, this is the end of the section where I had to re-record commentary, so from this point on, it'll be commentary while it's happening. Enjoy.